With Python, Robot Framework and PyCharm correctly installed, we can now go ahead and start creating our first Robot Framework script and actually dive into the launch of an automation project. For that, I'm going to create a text file right in the project that I already created, and I will give it the robot extension. If you remember from the last videos, we stated that Robot Framework scripts are nothing else but text files with robot extension. For that, I'm going to right click on the tests folder and I will choose new file. I will give it a name like test case 1.robot. Because IntelliBot has been correctly installed also, we can now see that the robot file has been correctly recognized, and we can see this little icon here, which means that what we are going to do from this point on will be recognized as a robot framework syntax. Now, a robot framework test case can have a maximum of 4 sections, and we will discuss each and every one of them in the following sessions. The first section is the settings section. If I start typing settings, you will see that IntelliBot already provides me with this syntax, and this is the way of writing each section name. So 3 stars followed by a space, the name, and then 3 stars at the end. The second section is the keywords section. We can also have a variables section and a test cases section. For a robot framework script, the settings section and the test cases section are mandatory, because without them we won't be able to execute any robot framework script. For this example, I'm going to use all 4 of them, and I will explain to you what is the particularity of each section. So before starting explaining the settings section, I would also like to give you some hints on how you can improve your overall experience with writing robot framework test cases in PyCharm. And for that, I'm going to teach you how to apply 2 simple tweaks to make your life easier. As you can see, the font in this particular window is not very big. And for those of you who may have 4K monitors, this could also be a problem, because the font of the text would be so small, you wouldn't actually be able to read it without getting very close to your monitor. So what can we do about that? Well, there is a setting inside PyCharm that allows you to increase or decrease the font size with control and mouse wheel. And that setting can be found in File, Settings, and under General, so Editor, General, we can see that there is an option here, Change Font Size with Control plus Mouse Wheel. I will click on this, I will click Apply, OK. And now if I hit Control and scroll with the mouse wheel, I can see that the font of my script is getting bigger or smaller depending on the direction I am scrolling with the mouse wheel. So this is very handy when you are working with complex scripts and have a lot of lines of codes. One other setting that will make your project look beautiful is a setting for displaying your keywords. For example, if I want to type in a keyword that belongs to the built-in library, so for example, if I want to type in run keyword if, you can see that this is written in small letters, but it would be much nice if we would actually have it written in capital letters, at least for the first character of a word. So how can we do that? Well, this is another setting from the IntelliBot plugin. So all we have to do is to go to File, Settings, Languages and Framework, Robot Options, and I will click Capitalize Keywords and hit Apply. Now, when I'm trying to type in the same keyword, you can see that if I start typing with capital letter, the keyword itself will be written like this. So each first letter or character of my keyword is written with capital letter. As you can see in this case, for me at least, it makes a great difference when it comes to the ease of creating and reading a test case. Okay. Let's move on and talk about the settings section. Why is it important? Well, in the settings section, there are many things you can put, and we will discuss about all of them along the way. But for now, what you need to remember is that in the settings section, we will declare libraries. Because Robot Framework is keyword driven, it means that in order to create Robot Framework scripts, we need to execute keywords. But what are keywords? Well, keywords are lines that execute a certain action or define a certain action. And these keywords are put into libraries. If you remember from our first video on robotframework.org, we had a library section where we could find the standard libraries and the external libraries and other. All the keywords that belong to these libraries can be easily called out into a Robot Framework script without having to install any of them. For example, in the built-in library, if we Google it and we open the page, we can see that there are a lot of keywords that are composing this library. You can go ahead and read about them yourself, because as you can see, the names are not that difficult to understand. Let's say that, for example, I want to use a keyword that belongs to the operating system library. We will go to the operating system keywords page, and here we can find all the keywords that are composed under this library. So this means that I can call any keyword and execute an action. For example, if I want to count files in a directory, I can click on this keyword and I can see that there are explanations about what this keyword does and how to use it. But if I want to go into my script and call in this keyword, for example, let's say count files, count files in directory, I can see that this command is underlined, which means that it is not recognized. And the reason for that is because Robot Framework needs to know which library you are using to call out a keyword. The way you can import a library is to go under the settings section and type in library. As I type in li, you can see that I am already getting suggestion for this keyword. I will click enter, and you can see that now I have multiple spaces between my declaration and what I'm going to type in next. This is one of the things you should and must remember about Robot Framework, that between the declaration of a keyword or a function, you need to have at least two spaces so you can type in the value or the next set of strings. So for example, I want to use this keyword that is declared inside the operating system library. So I will copy this name. I will make sure here that I have at least two spaces, but you can also use the tab key on your keyboard, and I will type in operating system. If I press on the control key and I hover over this name, I can see that now the library is recognized, and inside my test case, the keyword I tried to type in earlier is also recognized. So with control and click, I can go to the declaration of the keyword that I wanted to type inside my test script. Because now I imported the operating system library, I can call any other keyword that is under this library. So for example, if I want to type in remove directory, now PyCharm and IntelliBot know that this keyword belongs to the operating system library, and I can call it just like this. So this is how you use the settings section. Of course, the settings section can be used also to declare a documentation. What this does is to put in your final log of execution details about your test case. So for example, this test case is my first test case, and I want to put in a documentation that says exactly that. So I will type in, this is my first test case. For now, this is all we need to know about the settings section. It can be used for the documentation, and it can be used to import a library of commands. Let us now try to actually execute something. So inside the built-in library, we do have a keyword that is called log. And what this does is simply logging a message. And I will try to do that now. As you can see, it has some arguments that are needed. Some of them are mandatory and some of them are not. We will also cover this part in the future videos when we get down to keywords. But right now, let's simply log a message and say, this is a sample test case. Okay? I am not using a keyword from the operating system library, but that's okay. It doesn't hurt if I had the operating system library declared, but I'm not using it. So now let's see what happens. If I'm opening up a terminal, I can see that I'm at the location where my project has been created. So in order to execute my test case, I can type in robot, which is the command used to execute a robot script. And then I will point it to the location of my actual test case. So the robot command is executed inside the test project folder, and my actual test case is in the tests folder. So I will type in tests / and the name of the test case I want to execute. In my case, that would be test case 1.robot. And the execution took very little time. I can see that the thing I wrote in the documentation appears in the terminal, and also I have an execution status. We will talk about executing test cases and how to interpret logs and results in the future videos. I will see you soon.